Hello and welcome to Encore. It's time for our weekly movie roundup. We get a look inside the world of Olympic-level wrestling with the dark and unsettling Foxcatcher. Actress and producer Reese Witherspoon strikes out and takes to the open road in Jean-Marc Vallée's film Wild. And a young man tries to find his way between the pressures of family, school and a new country in French film Young Tiger. For all that, I'm joined by our resident film critic, Lisa Nesselson. So let's get started. Lisa, thanks for joining us. Now, we're starting off with some news from the Riviera. The Cannes Film Festival has chosen this year's jury president, or presidents plural, Joel and Ethan Coen. No strangers to the festival. They've picked up an award or two themselves. Lisa, what can we expect from these two brothers?
Oh, I think that's an excellent choice. They really are regulars at Cannes. They've won the top award in 1991 for Barton Fink and a lot of awards along the way. One of the most interesting things about a jury president, or presidents as you say, is that they get to invite some of their friends or people they've always wanted to work with. So I imagine it'll be a pretty interesting group of accomplished people.
Okay, looking forward to some perhaps different additions there at the Cannes Film Festival. Now, we're moving on to new releases here in France. This one's based on a true story that examines the bizarre intersection of extreme wealth and Olympic wrestling in the US in the 1980s. Lisa, tell us a bit more about Foxcatcher.
Well, like you say, it's about wrestling, which is a sport that goes back to antiquity, and it's about jealousy, which is something that sort of goes along with being human. A healthy mind and a healthy body, that's the slogan. In this case, a twisted mind and a very impressive prosthetic nose makes all the difference. Steve Carell has been nominated for an Oscar for playing John E. DuPont, and he makes the character truly, truly disturbing. Now, Mark Schultz, very well played by Channing Tatum, and his brother Dave, very well played by Mark Ruffalo, are the only brothers in history to have won both Olympic and World Wrestling Championships. Mark won a gold medal at the Los Angeles Olympics in 1984, but when we meet him, he is going absolutely nowhere fast. His brother Dave, on the other hand, has a family and a coaching job. So when Mark gets an invitation out of absolutely nowhere to come train for the 1988 Seoul Olympics on the estate of multimillionaire DuPont, he accepts, and he tries to get his gregarious brother to join him, at first to no avail. Let's take a look.
What do you hope to achieve, Mark?
I want to be the best in the world.
Good.
He would like Foxcatcher to be the official training site for the national team.
What's he get out of all this?
What are you thinking? This is it. This is all that we've ever wanted.
Coaches, a father. Coaches, a mentor. Coach has great power on an athlete's life.
So, like you say, we can see jealousy, we can see brotherly relationships, but mainly, I mean, a lot of wrestling. Do you have to be into wrestling to get involved with this story?
Absolutely not. My interest in wrestling really doesn't go much further than spelling the word correctly, if I ever have to spell it. But I was glued to my seat during this. I really was. It's so intensely eerie and convincing, full of dark corners, the sordid underbelly of success, American style. DuPont fancies himself a great patriot, and I have to say some of his pronouncements really had me cringing. Director Bennett Miller's first two films, you may be familiar with, they were also terrific, also based on true stories. Capote, with the late Philip Seymour Hoffman, and Moneyball with Brad Pitt. This is very, very compelling storytelling.
Okay, looking forward to that then. Now, we're staying with true stories or adapted versions of true stories. The film Wild is based on one woman's memoir and a 1,000-mile hike that she took along the Pacific coast. Now, what did you make of this film?
Well, I know this is supposed to be a feminist journey of self-discovery, and Reese Witherspoon is now Oscar-nominated Reese Witherspoon for this performance, and director Jean-Marc Vallée's previous film was the incredibly, incredibly good, excellent Dallas Buyers Club. But my reaction, since you ask, is sort of, There's nothing I can point to being wrong, outright wrong, about the film. It's just not that interesting. Of course, I think it's really, really important to tell women's stories on screen, but without giving anything away, Cheryl Strayed, on whose real-life memoir this is based, and it was a bestseller, she figures out that having been a promiscuous heroin addict because her mother died young was just one of those things that went into building her personality and making her the wonderful person she is today. Here's one of the film's more entertaining episodes. Let's watch.
I interview hobos for the Hobo Times, drive all over the USA, and I have to tell you, lady hobos, hard to find.
I think you're mistaken. I'm not a hobo.
So, how long have you been out on the road?
I'm not on the road. I'm hiking the Pacific Crest Trail. I just had to bypass a chunk of it because there was a snowfall this year.
Okay, so if you're not a hobo, where do you live?
I'm between places right now. I'm probably gonna live in Portland when I get off the PCT.
I've only spoken to maybe one other female hobo in 2 years.
Let me reiterate to you, I'm not a hobo. And that's probably because women can't walk out of their lives. They've got kids to take care of, they've got parents to look after.
You sound like a feminist.
I am.
That's excellent. It's fantastic. I love feminists.
Like we said, that was a memoir, in fact, a best-selling book. Cheryl Strayed's become something of a personality in the American media. Surely that's an interesting story to tell.
Well, I haven't read the book. Apparently, it's very compelling. The movie, that was really one of the most interesting scenes. A lot of it is just her and her thoughts and her way, way, way too heavy backpack making her way through the wilderness. Of course, it's one of those stories where she just says, I'm going to do this thing, and is incredibly underprepared. And so we're supposed to be rooting for her. I just didn't find her that compelling. I don't know how else to put it.
Yeah, well, so it seems like Reese Witherspoon's going into kind of Erin Brockovich territory there with a kind of, you know, strong story. Now, we're coming back to Europe, and we're taking a look at the first film by French writer-director Cyprien Vial, which examines the dilemma of being a fish out of water, or even being totally out of your depth. Tell me a bit more about this film.
Now, this movie really grabbed me. While teaching audiovisual courses in the Paris suburbs, the director met young men from the Punjab region of India, whose parents spent a lot of money to send them unaccompanied to France. And they don't really have the right to be here, but if they're minors under age 18, well, then the state takes care of them until they come of age. This isn't something they advertise, since they've got their hands full with immigrants as it is, but it's a very benevolent policy, I think. So our protagonist, Manny, arrives at age 15. He's placed in a foster home, enrolled in school, learns French, seems to be thriving under the protection of the French state 2 years later. Let's take a look.
Je m'appelle Manny, j'ai 17 ans, je viens du Punjab.
C'est un bon dossier, Manny. Et c'est la garantie pour espérer décrocher la nationalité française après.
Tu vas chez moi après les cours?
Ouais, je peux pas, je taffe.
Et vos parents veulent que vous leur envoyiez de l'argent. Mais il va falloir qu'ils attendent parce que dans notre pays, les enfants ne travaillent pas.
Vas-y, t'aurais pas un boulot pour moi?
T'es lié à des trucs à vite.
Maintenant, tu t'assois et tu nous dis ce que tu fais de tes journées.
Tu travailles pour qui?
Personne.
So as you can see, his family back in India very seriously expects him to be sending money back to them. And there's some very tense phone calls along those lines. But the only way for him to do that is to work illegally, because you're not supposed to be working at that age. So Manny is stuck between a rock and a hard place and another rock and another harder place. The director said that, you know, he doesn't admire that many people in real life. But the young men that this was based on, he said he has enormous admiration for them, because he's not sure from his costume and upbringing that he ever would have been able to cope with all these elements. The director came to France 24, and I got to ask him whether he thinks France has found a solution to this kind of immigration. This is what he had to say.
My position is very ambivalent. I do not judge, I observe, and what I observed is both very encouraging and quite tragic. I cannot tell the end of the story, but the end is very, well, ambivalent, and for me, the Republic hasn't found the way in this niche of integration to really help those children as well as it should.
Definitely a new take on the issue of immigration here in France, that one. And, of course, Cyprien Vial, a brand new talent there. But I know you're a fan of older films as well. I should imagine that you'll be checking out the festival at the Cinémathèque of Restored Classics here in
Absolutely.
Paris.
Absolutely. This is coming up from January 28th through February 1st. It's the third edition of Toute la mémoire du monde, which is a grandiose title for a mini-festival of restored films from all over the world, held at the Cinémathèque Française and absolutely open to everybody. You know, France still has an extremely strong repertory cinema culture, which means that old films don't ever lose their value. Nobody says, oh, that's from 1959 and it's in black and white. Surely you don't believe me to believe I should pay full price for that. So this year, the guest of honor is Francis Ford Coppola. He'll be giving a masterclass and showing Peggy Sue Got Married and all three episodes of The Godfather, which have been restored. Other highlights include a restored print of John Waters' 1981 Polyester to be shown in Odorama with scratch and sniff cards. And also Roman Polanski's 1971 version of Macbeth, which he's going to introduce in person. If you're a Sherlock Holmes film, they found a film from 1960 they believed was lost, and they're going to play it with a musical trio recreating the original sound effects. And if you simply must see films in color, well, the restored Gone with the Wind, if you've got about 4 hours, is part of the program, as is the original A Star is Born.
Oh, definitely worth four hours of your time, I think. Well, thank you, Lisa, for being with us. We'll leave you with some of the highlights of Coppola's three Godfather films. Remember to check out our website. We're also on Facebook and on Twitter. There's more news coming up on France 24 after this.
Seguiamo, ci siete d'accordo? Perché numerate 50 scudi l'uno per pagare a Fanucci?
Mio padre, come si chiama?
Tony Mandolini.
Spend time with your family? Unless a man that doesn't spend time with his family can never be a real man.
La più piano e nessuno sentirà il nostro amore lo.